Thank you. Good afternoon. I don't think I need to repeat it, but I will. All are welcome. Happy that you can be with us to do it in song, and now in the name of the Lord, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Welcome to our celebration of the Word and the Eucharist, and to see in ways in which we can find those who might be lost and invite them to return.
Lord Jesus, you seek us when we are lost. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ Jesus, you forgive us when we leave you. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord Jesus, you rejoice when we return to you. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Let us pray. Look upon us, O God, creator and ruler of all things, and that we may feel the working of your mercy, grant that we may serve you with all our heart. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen.
A proclamation from the book of Exodus. The Lord said to Moses, "Go down at once. Your people, whom you brought up out of the land of Egypt, have acted perversely. They've been quick to turn aside from the way that I commanded them. They have cast for themselves an image of a calf and have worshiped it and sacrificed to it and said, 'These are your gods, O Israel, who brought you up out of the land of Egypt.'" The Lord then said to Moses, "I have seen this people, how stiff-necked they are. Now let me alone so that my wrath may burn hot against them and I may consume them. And of you I will make a great nation." But Moses implored the Lord his God and said, "O Lord, why does your wrath burn hot against your people, whom you brought out of the land of Egypt with great power and a mighty hand? Remember Abraham, Isaac, and Israel, your servants, how you swore to them by your own self, saying to them, 'I will multiply your descendants like the stars of heaven, and all this land that I have promised I will give to your descendants, and they shall inherit it forever.'" And the Lord changed his mind about the disaster he had planned to bring on his people. The word of the Lord.
Thank you.
Beloved, I am a proclamation from the first letter of St. Paul to Timothy. Beloved, I am grateful to Christ Jesus our Lord, who has strengthened me because he judged me faithful and appointed me to his service, even though I was formerly a blasphemer, a persecutor, and a man of violence. But I received mercy because I had acted ignorantly in unbelief, and the grace of our Lord overflowed for me with the faith and love that are in Christ Jesus. The saying is sure and worthy of full acceptance, that Christ Jesus came into the world to save sinners, of whom I am the foremost. But for that very reason, I received mercy, so that in me, as the foremost, Jesus Christ might display the utmost patience, making me an example to those who would come to believe in him for eternal life. To the King of the ages, immortal, invisible, the only God, be honor and glory forever and ever. Amen. The word of the Lord.
The Lord be with you. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Luke. My mind, my lips, and my heart. Tax collectors and sinners were all drawing near to listen to Jesus, but the Pharisees and scribes began to complain, saying, "This man welcomes sinners and eats with them." So to them, he addressed this parable. "What one among you having 100 sheep and losing one of them would not leave the 99 and go after the one lost until it is found? And when he finds it, that one sets it on his shoulders with great joy, and upon his arrival home, calls together friends and neighbors and says to them, 'Rejoice, we found the lost sheep.' I tell you, in just the same way, there will be more joy in heaven over one sinner who repents than over 99 righteous people who have no need for repentance? Or, what woman, having 10 coins and losing one, would not light a lamp, sweep the house, searching carefully until she finds it? And when she finds it, she calls together her friends and neighbors and says to them, "Rejoice with me, because I found the coin that was lost." The Gospel of the Lord. I know many of you read the scriptures ahead of time, and you might wonder why I didn't continue the gospel. We have two choices this weekend as preachers, to choose the short version, the lost sheep and the lost coin, or to choose the longer version, which includes the lost son and the forgiving father, the parable of the prodigal son. I chose to do the first two only, not just out of mercy for you, because the other gospel is much, much longer, but I think we get the same essence, because there's a theme between all three. When there is something that is lost, there's great joy when it's found. When I think about particularly the lost sheep, I feel like Spock. Any of you know Spock? Live long and prosper. I'm actually doing it, kind of. I have a hard time doing that. Spock was logical. Everything in his mind was absolutely logical. Otherwise, it didn't make any sense. I will admit to you that sometimes when I read the Gospels, I find them illogical. Remember last week? Remember Jesus said, we have to hate our father and mother, sister and brother, spouse and child to follow him? Now, wait a minute. That's illogical. Jesus loved his father and mother. What's up with that? I feel like Spock. Well, when we broke that open, I'm not sure what Father Dennis and Father Ken, or Father Jerry, I think, was here last week too. We broke open at Good Shepherd that what Christ was saying is, when we follow Christ, everything is secondary, even family. God is first. Christ is first, even family. He was trying to shock his disciples by saying you have to hate your father and mother. In fact, the original language, it was really more you have to leave your father and mother. But anyway, illogical, right? So today we have the lost sheep. So it's as if we're hearing instructions saying that when the one is lost, we should leave the 99 and go find the one as followers of Jesus, as Jesus himself would, the Good Shepherd. But wait a minute, that's illogical. Who's going to take care of the 99 while the shepherd is gone? Who's going to feed them, protect them, and care for them? What's Christ trying to tell us this time? I think maybe we should reverse perspective. When I was a video producer, we used to shoot some videos that are called point of view, POV. So basically, you were the eyes of the actor or actress. So point of view, you're seeing what's going on. Let's take the point of view of the sheep. Rather than the shepherd, which I think is our inclination, let's take the point of view of the sheep. So I wonder, as sheep, today lost sheep, I'll bet there are people in here right now that are lost. I think we've all been lost sometime in our life, if we're honest. But right now, and I don't speak of being physically lost, you know where you are, St. James Parish in Menomonee Falls, Wisconsin. Lost spiritually, lost mentally. Not sure what to do, what path and what road to take. I think we can all relate that sometimes we are lost in our faith. Maybe we're lost in a career decision or a job. What should we do? Maybe we're lost emotionally. We're depressed. or we have a family member who's in time of trouble. We're lost. Having all been lost sometimes, what's it feel like when either some person reaches out to you and perhaps unknowingly, because you may not show that you're lost, what does it feel like when somebody connects with you and lifts you up and brings you back into the community? Feels magnificent, doesn't it? Feels wonderful. What Christ is trying to get us in touch with today is the love that God has for us. He's trying to get us in touch with how God feels when we return, if our faith has swayed, or perhaps we've done something we know is wrong and we go for the sacrament of reconciliation. God rejoices so much when we return, so much so I don't think we can imagine how much Christ and God rejoice when we return. So who are the lost in here? Hard to know unless we admit it. I had a very unusual opportunity this morning. Once a year, the Episcopal and Catholic deacons come together for a day of ecumenism, recognizing each other's gifts and what we do in service as deacons. Interestingly, in the Episcopal community, that includes some women who are ordained deacons there. Interesting perspective for us to get. Now, this year, we hosted it at Good Shepherd, and we invited Hasim Abdullah Babutu. He is a Muslim. His faith is Islam. And he came with four of his brothers to be in solidarity with us and believers in the same God, Allah, God, Yahweh for the Jews, the Great Spirit for the Native American, the same God. And Hasim came having formed a group that's called hashtag Get to Know a Muslim. And the reason they want to come out into communities like deacons and communities like Good Shepherd, they'd like to come to St. James as well to talk to us, it's because they want to shake our hands. They want to embrace us and let us know they're not extremists and terrorists. There are factions within the Muslim community that are. Folks, there are factions within the Christian community that are extremists and terrorists. But their desire was to shake our hands, embrace us, call us brother and sister, and to say to us, this is their slogan, love for all, hatred for none. What does it sound like? Christ's great commandment, love God, love neighbor, love self. I pose to you that they're lost sheep. There's only 365 of them in Milwaukee. There are probably more because they don't want to tell anybody they're Muslim because they're hated. They're feared. They're shunned. They didn't leave the flock. They were pushed out of the flock. Who are the others in our society that are lost and need somebody, maybe us, Christ through us, reaching out to them? How about the homeless in the tent city? Do you know about the tent city in Milwaukee? I used to go to the train station a lot. I worked in Chicago. And where the Amtrak and bus station is, it's now called the Intermodal Station, immediately across St. Paul Avenue, there is hundreds of tents. They've actually been donated by businesses in Milwaukee for the homeless. The homeless who are mentally ill that are afraid to go into the shelters. They're lost. Nobody wants anything to do with them. They're under an overpass in a tent, and they'll go through this winter living in those tents. There are others. We won't have to go into all of them, but when we're lost and then found, we can relate to how God feels when we return. We're being called today to look for those who were lost, to shake their hand, to embrace them and tell them, you're welcome here. You're welcome in the Catholic Church. You're welcome at Good Shepherd. You're welcome at St. James. God wants us. God loves us. God is constantly searching for us. And God wants us to do the same on his behalf. When you leave here today, please contemplate who's lost and can we help them come back?
In response to God's word, we invite you to join in the profession of faith on page 10.
We live in a world that is not very forgiving. May our church be a model of acceptance and forgiveness. For our church, we pray. We heard in the first reading today how stiff-necked we can be. In the wake of 9/11 remembrances, may the nations stop seeking vengeance and retaliation, instead willing to forgive and offer peace, even when wronged. We pray. Many in our world are lost like sheep, separated from the resources they need to sustain a basic dignified life. May leaders in all walks of life, including religious, government, business, and community and family leaders, actively reach out to all who are in need. We pray. We pray for the sick and suffering. God, we ask that you remind all sick and the ill in our community that you care about them, that you love them, even in their time of hardship. For the sick and suffering, we pray. We bring to you, God, all those prayers that are written in our prayer intention book in our lobby. And we remember all the deceased members of St. James that are signed in our Book of Life. And we remember especially Roxanne Schaefer, Lolly and Norbert Knippel, and Ray Schadel, whom we remember today in a special way at this Mass. For these we pray.
Lord God, help us to recall the times in our lives where we were lost, literally, or in other ways, and other people came to our rescue. May we do the same always through Christ our Lord.
Thank you.
Pray, my brothers and sisters, that our offering this evening may be acceptable to God the Father Almighty. Look with favor on our supplications, O Lord, and in your kindness accept these, your servants' offerings, that what each has offered to the honor of your name may serve the salvation of all. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
Lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is
truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give thanks to you, Father most holy, through your beloved Son, Jesus Christ, your word through whom you made all things, whom you sent as our Redeemer and Savior, incarnate by the Holy Spirit and born of the Virgin Mary. Fulfilling your will and gaining for you a holy people, he stretched out his hands as he endured his passion, so as to break the bonds of death and manifest the resurrection. And so, with the angels and all the saints, we declare your glory as with one voice we acclaim. You are indeed holy, O Lord, the font of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread, and giving thanks, he broke it, and he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat it. For this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the cup, and once again giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you held us worthy to be in your presence and to minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world. Bring her the fullness of charity, together with Francis our Pope, Jerome our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, the Mother of God, with Joseph, her spouse, with all the blessed apostles, including James, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, All glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Amen.
We pray now to God our Father in the words which Jesus our Lord had given us. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
Let's offer each other now a sign of peace.
Behold the Lamb of God, behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those who are called to the supper of the Lamb. Those taking communion to our brothers and sisters who are not with us this evening are invited to come forward. It's good to see so many of you willing to do this. I'm sure it means a whole lot to them to be connected with us in prayer, but also in sharing the body and blood of our Lord. We ask, O Lord, that you bless these communion distributors and those who receive. May we always be mindful of you in life and also in worship. Through Christ our Lord.
These are the announcements for the weekend. The Fall Art and Environment Committee needs help setting up the fall decor in the worship and gathering space. Setup will be tomorrow after the 10:30 Mass. All are welcome, and it's a great way to meet new people. Our health ministry is offering blood pressure screening as well as hearing screening in the Great Room after Mass. As the Milwaukee Archdiocese is celebrating its 175th anniversary, parishes are asked to participate in local service opportunities called 7 Days of Service. Please consult this week's bulletin to see the number of opportunities available for your participation. Please join our faith community in participating in this most important service to our sisters and brothers in need. And as always, for more information about the activities here at St. James, please check out the bulletin, website, and Facebook.
It's not often you see me come to this music stand versus the ambo, the table of the word. It's because when I was installed by the Archbishop, I was asked to handle the spiritual and the temporal needs of the parish, and I'm here to speak to you about a temporal need. I think you've already become aware with some statements that have been made at this same music stand from our finance council about a particularly difficult time of financial reality. And what has happened to us is that over the summer months, we have experienced a large number of unforeseen, unbudgeted emergency expenses. Every year we put in the budget an amount that is kind of a placeholder so that we don't know what might fail, but we have something in the budget. We've done that every year. But this year it was one thing after another, after another, after another, to the total of $175,000 of emergency at-once need. So we've taken the following action under the guidance of Terry Weber. We have gone, we considered many options, but we went to the bank and now have received a line of credit. And we submitted to the Archdiocese a proxy, which we must submit and get it approved before we can execute the line of credit. We've received both the line of credit, and just in fact, before Mass, Terry handed me the proxy which came in today. So that's the challenge in front of us. That's the honest reality. Here's where we are. You're going to get a letter. They're being mailed tomorrow. That's going to give you a little bit more detail, and we'll give you a list of some of these things that have failed. And you're being asked to help us above and beyond what you're already contributing. I know that's difficult. I'm being asked to do the same thing. But here's a couple of things I think that are not overwhelming for us. If each family gave $50 between now and the end of our fiscal year, which is June, we would take a large chunk out of paying back that line of credit. If every family gave $150, we could pay off the line of credit. So it's not this overwhelming, insurmountable task. We want to pay it off within 2 years, $50 on average per family will help us get close to that. $150 will help us get all the way there. So that's the ask. That's what you're going to be seeing. We also are going to do more in the future because our building now is 20 years old, and just like our homes, it is the roof, it is the siding, it is the sump pump, it is the air conditioner, it is the septic, it is the laterals for sewer, you name it, it failed. So that's the condition. We want to be transparent with you. Pray, and I'm sure we will overcome this. We've overcome many more difficult things in the past. I thank you for receiving this message and for praying and considering helping us move out of this time of financial hardship. Thank you. While I have your attention, Father is going to join me. When I turn the other microphone on, Father is going to join me, and I'm going to try and not trip and kill myself. I'm going to call forth now pilgrims. We have a pilgrimage going from St. James Parish to both Fatima and to Lourdes. If you would come onto the step and face the community, please. And I believe this is just some of who will be going. Two are missing, so there's two others. Brothers and sisters, as you set out on your pilgrimage, be mindful of the reason you go on this holy pilgrimage. The place you intend to visit is a monument to the devotion of the people of God. Many have preceded you in great numbers to be strengthened in the Christian way of life and to become more determined to devote themselves more fully to the works of the church. By your witness, you will be an example for all of us of faith, hope, and love. We ask now that the entire community, while seated, extend your hands over these pilgrims, and Father will give God's blessing to them.
First of all, I envy you because I've been to both places and they're terrific examples of faith, Catholic faith in the church and our Blessed Mother. So when you're there, please remember us in your prayers, okay? All-powerful God, you always show mercy toward those who love you, and you are never far away from those who seek you. Remain with your servants on their holy pilgrimage and guide their way in accord with your will. Shelter them with your protection by day. Give them the light of your grace by night. And as their companion on the journey, bring them to their destiny in safety. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen. Let us thank them for representing us on this pilgrimage.
Be sure to say Hail Mary for us when you're there.
Okay. And we will say one for you
there
as well.
There you go.
Let's stand.
May the working of this heavenly gift, O Lord, we pray, take possession of our minds and bodies so that it's at its effects, not in our own desires, but always to prevail in you. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
And may Almighty God bless you, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Go now in peace, seeking the Lord if lost, and looking for those others who are lost, as we love and serve the Lord.
And as we go forth, let us sing How Great is Our God, found in page 42.
Begin with the